Goody's Headache Powder presents this week's World Championship Wrestling Headache of the Week. And this week we feature on one of the horsemen, the biggest horseman of them all, Sid Vicious, 6 feet nine, 338 pounds. His patented maneuver, it's the power bomb. Vicious says he'll be the next world's heavyweight champion. What a headache to Sting. This week's WCW Headache of the Week.
The following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first from, well, he says it's no one's business where he's from, 338 pounds, representing the horseman, Sid Vicious. His opponent from Iowa City, Iowa, 215 pounds, Jamie McKinnon.
6 feet nine, 338 pounds. He made some comments just a little bit earlier today. Let's listen to the comments of Big Sid Vicious.
Sting, a little message you might want to listen to. You messed around and you lucked up and you got that title. Well, I'm coming to get it and I'm going to take it back where it belongs with the Four Horsemen, Punk.
He is one of the most awesome competitors I've ever seen in my career in wrestling. Bob, 6'9", 338 pounds, and he is Edston Granite. Oh, good Lord, what a clothesline.
Intimidation with a capital I is this big man.
And it seems as if the horsemen are preparing this big monster mentally and physically to perhaps challenge Sting for the heavyweight championship of the world.
I'm sure that Ole Anderson probably has something like that in the back of his mind. Jim, I was looking at McKimmon. You got to say he is just tremendously overmatched. When he signed this match, he had visions of grandeur in his mind to go against a man like Sid Vicious.
Iowa City, Iowa. The Iowa Hawkeyes. He may never see another home game that they play.
I'll tell you.
Coach Hayden Fry up there in the Big Ten.
Give him the trophy for bravery of the night anyway to get in against a man like
this. Oh, wow. Side slam, and he just jams him down. He is so sadistic. And here comes that. Is it going to be the power bomb or a backbreaker? Or whatever he wants.
He's an athlete, Jim. I can't believe it.
What a move by Sid Vicious. We have seen him use that move in the past, but not in quite some time. I'm sure that the horsemen, including Ole Anderson, are looking at the film, but that is such high impact. Sting or Lex Luger cannot withstand that move. No one can. This man is devastating.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Sid Vicious.
Bob, we'll hear some comments from Ole Anderson in just a moment who may shed more light on what's in store for Sid Vicious. But right now, we're going to take another look. This is Impact.
Impact and power, a capital P again, as Vicious has McKimmon up. Watch the force and the power with that backbreaker when he drives him down to the mat. But here's that airplane spin. Look how far out he threw him, almost halfway across the ring.
Big Sid Vicious, as bad as they come. And he's got one more move left for Jamie McKinnon, and we're going to see it. Watch the power bomb. This is the man that might well rule wrestling in the 90s. Could it be Sid Vicious? He'll have something to say about it. If not, and here's another man that'll have something to say about it, Ole Anderson.
I want you all to pay attention. You know, I've been the spokesman for a horseman for quite some time. And the one thing that I could always be proud of saying is that the horsemen were the elite of the wrestling world. And why? Because we had all the belts. World title, tag team title, and television title. But now, a turn of events has changed things. I tried to warn Sting, I tried to warn Luger, I warned everybody. We're not people to fool with. The horsemen only have one title now, and that's the television title. But I'll tell you what, it won't be much longer before we will have that world title once again. There's one man in the stable who's capable of taking that title, And he's the biggest man in wrestling, and I'm not talking about the total package. You watch this man, because somehow, someway, he's going to be the champion. I'm talking about Sid Vicious.